예수님은 이 세상에 우리의 죄를 용서하기 위해 오셨습니다. 십자가에 달리시고 피를 흘려 죽으셨습니다. 십자가에서 죽으신 몸과 흘리신 그 피로 우리의 모든 죄가 다 깨끗하게 되었습니다. 예수님은 십자가에서 죽으시기 전에 마지막으로 제자들과 식사를 하였습니다. 그리고 식사에서 먹은 빵과 포도주가 예수님의 몸과 피라고 하셨습니다. 예수님을 믿는 모든 우리 친구들도 예수님의 몸과 피를 기억하며 감사드렸으면 합니다. 다 같이 기도드리고 예배 시작하겠습니다. 하나님 감사합니다. 예수님께서 우리들에게 많은 사랑을 주셨습니다. 그 중에 가장 큰 사랑은 예수님께서 십자가에서 우리의 죄 때문에 죽으신 사랑입니다. 그 사랑에 감사하며 찬양을 드립니다. 예수님 이름으로 기도합니다. 아멘. Jesus came to this world to forgive our sins. He hung on the cross and bled to death. All our sins have been cleaned by the body that died on the cross and the blood that you shed. Jesus ate the last dinner with his disciples before he died on the cross. And he said that the bread and the wine he ate at the dinner were Jesus' body and blood. I hope all our New Hope kids who believe in Jesus also remember and thank Jesus' body and blood. Let's pray together and start to worship. Dear God, Jesus gave us a lot of the lovers. The greatest love among them is the love Jesus died on a cross because of our sins. Thank you for the love and the praise. I pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
새소망 친구들, 비록 코로나 때문에 집에서 온라인으로 예배를 드리지만 우리 하나님께 최선을 다해 예배드려요. 예배드리기 전에 친구들이 지켜야 할 온라인 예배 에티켓 함께 알아볼까요? 첫 번째, 화장실은 미리미리 다녀오세요. 예배 중간에 화장실 가지 않기로 약속해요. 두 번째, 단정한 옷으로 갈아입고 하나님께 예의를 갖춰 예배드려요. 세 번째, 찬양할 땐 기쁜 마음으로 일어나서 드리기로 해요. 네 번째, 예배 시간에 누워 있거나 간식 먹지 않기로 약속해요. 온라인 예배 에티켓 모두 지켜줄 수 있죠? 자, 그럼 모두 자리에 일어나 선생님과 함께 기쁜 마음으로 찬양합시다.
시편 67편 Psalm 67 교독문 같이 읽겠습니다. T teacher 선생님이 읽고요. C children 여러분들이 읽겠습니다. 시작합니다. God, have mercy on us and bless us. Show your kindness to us.
Then the world will learn your ways.
All nations will learn that you can save. God, the people should praise you.
All people should praise you.
The nation should be glad and sing.
Because you judge people fairly,
you guide all the nations on earth. God, the people should praise you. The land has given its crops.
God, our God blesses us.
God blesses us,
so people to the ends of the earth will fear him.
Amen.
계속해서 우리 친구들이 예배를 위해 기도를 드리고 있습니다. 오늘은 정현이가 우리를 위해 기도 드립니다. 다 같이 기도 드리겠습니다. New Hope Kids continue to pray for worship. Today, 정현 is praying for us. Let's all pray together.
하나님 감사합니다. 한 주 동안 지켜주시고 예배드리게 해주셔서 감사합니다. 예수님이 우리를 위해 십자가에서 돌아가시기까지 사랑해 주셔서 감사합니다. 우리도 예수님을 사랑할게요. 아멘.
정현이가 우리를 위해 드린 기도 감사합니다. 정현이가 기도한 것처럼 예수님이 우리들에게 주신 제일 큰 사랑은 십자가에서 죽으신 것입니다. 그 사랑으로 말미암아 우리의 죄가 용서되었습니다. 사랑하는 것은 희생이 따라야 합니다. 이기적이면 절대 다른 사람을 사랑할 수 없습니다. 우리 친구들 예수님처럼 희생의 사랑을 배우고 실천하기를 바랍니다. 정현이가 아직 이곳에 온 지 얼마 되지 않았습니다. 예수님께서 정현이의 친구가 되어서 늘 함께 하기를 바랍니다. 앞으로 아프지 않고 또 공부도 잘하고 또 하나님을 잘 섬기는 귀한 하나님의 자녀가 되기를 예수님의 이름으로 축복합니다. 아멘. 오늘은 예수님께서 십자가에서 죽으시기 전 제자들과 마지막 만찬을 하시는 이야기입니다. 먼저 성경 말씀 듣겠습니다. Today's story is that Jesus having his last dinner with his disciples before he died on a cross. Let's listen to the Bible verses first.
Now before the feast of the Passover, when Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart out of this world to the Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. During supper, when the devil had already put it into the heart of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, to betray him, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going back to God, rose from supper. He laid aside his outer garments, and taking a towel, tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was wrapped around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, do you wash my feet?" Jesus answered him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but afterward you will understand." Peter said to him, "You shall never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "If I do not wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "The one who has bathed does not need to wash except for his feet, but is completely clean. And you are clean, but not every one of you." For he knew who was to betray him. That was why he said, "Not all of you are clean." When When he had washed their feet and put on his outer garments and resumed his place, he said to them, Do you understand what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for so I am. If I then, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have given you an example that you also should do just as I have done to you. Now as they were eating, Jesus took bread, and after blessing it, broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, Take, eat, this is my body. And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink of it, all of you. For this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will not drink again of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives.
예수님은 그의 마지막 유월절 식사를 제자들과 함께 하였습니다. 유월절은 옛날 이스라엘 백성들이 이집트에 종으로 살 때 하나님의 은혜로 이집트에서 나와서 하나님이 약속한 땅으로 향하게 하신 것을 기념하는 날입니다. Jesus had his last Passover supper with his disciples. Passover is a day to commemorate the ancient Israel people who came out of Egypt by God's grace and had to land promised by God when they lived in Egypt as servants. 이 식사에서 예수님은 갑자기 제자들의 발을 씻겨줍니다. 이것은 그 당시 하인들이 하는 일이었습니다. 하지만 예수님은 제자들의 발을 씻겨주셨습니다. 예수님은 이것을 통해 다른 사람들을 겸손히 사랑하기를 우리들에게 가르쳐 주십니다. 그리고 우리들의 더러운 발이 깨끗하게 되는 것처럼 예수님이 우리들의 죄들을 깨끗하게 하심을 보여주십니다. At this supper that Jesus certainly washed his disciples' feet, this was what servants did at a time, but Jesus washed the feet of his disciples. Jesus teaches us to love others humbly through this. And Jesus shows us that he cleans our sins just as our dirty feet clean up. 이제 예수님은 빵을 들고 축사하시고 뜯어서 제자들에게 나누어 줍니다. 그리고 이 빵은 예수님 자신의 몸이라 하였습니다. 이제 예수님은 이 세상에 오셔서 우리의 죄를 용서하기 위해 드릴 희생 제물이 됩니다. 그리고 예수님은 포도주가 담긴 잔을 제자들에게 주면서 이 잔은 언약의 피라고 하셨습니다. 문 입구에 발려진 유월절 어린 양의 피가 생명을 지켜준 것처럼 이제 십자가에서 흘린 예수님의 피가 우리들의 모든 죄를 용서해 주실 생명의 피, 구원의 피가 됩니다. 예수님이 십자가에서 달리신 몸과 흘리신 피로 말미암아 우리가 죄에서 용서함을 받았고 하나님의 자녀가 되었습니다. Now Jesus holds bread, gave the prayer of thanks, they break it and gave it to his disciples. And this bread was set to be Jesus' body. Then now Jesus came to this world and became the sacrifice to forgive our sins. And Jesus gave his disciples a cup of the wine and said that it was the blood of the covenant. Just as the Passover lamb's blood at the door protected life, the blood of Jesus from the cross is now the blood of life and salvation that forgives all our sins. Through Jesus' body on the cross and the blood of his shed, we are forgiven from the sin and became the children of God. 우리 교회에서도 두 달에 한 번씩 예수님이 제자들에게 주신 빵과 포도주를 기념하고 있습니다. 이 행사는 예수님이 십자가에서 죽으신 몸과 흘린 피로 나의 죄가 깨끗하게 됨에 감사하며 기념하는 날입니다. 우리 친구들도 늘 예수님께서 십자가에서 죽으신 몸과 흘리신 피를 늘 기억하며 예수님 감사합니다. 예수님과 함께 살겠습니다. 그리고 예수님의 사랑을 다른 사람들에게도 나누겠습니다라고 고백하는 우리 친구들이 다 되기를 예수님 이름으로 축복합니다. 아멘. Our church also celebrates the bread and wine Jesus gave to his disciples every 2 months. This event is a day that we celebrate with thanks for the cleanness of our sins, with the body that died on a cross and the blood Jesus shed. Your kids should always remember the body Jesus died on a cross and the blood he shed. And thank you, Jesus. I will live with Jesus. I will share Jesus' loves with others. I bless all of your kids in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus washes his disciples' feet. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles like calming storms, and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
At this time, the Jewish people were celebrating a festival called Passover that had been celebrated since the time of Moses, when God brought his people out of Egypt. So Jesus and his disciples went to Jerusalem to celebrate. Jesus had 12 men who followed him through his ministry. They were called his disciples. Jesus and his disciples gathered for one final meal together. Jesus got up from the table, took off his robe, and began to wash his disciples' feet. Jesus loved his disciples, and he knew the time was coming for him to leave them and return to heaven. When Jesus came to Peter, he said,
"Whoa, whoa, whoa, wait!
Are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus said, "You don't understand what I'm doing now, but someday you will." Peter said, "You will never wash my feet." But Jesus then told him that unless he washed his feet, he would not belong to him.
Oh, well then, okay!
Then Peter said, "Then wash my hands and head as well, not just my feet." But Jesus told him that was not necessary. He just needed to wash his feet for Peter to become clean. So Jesus finished washing their feet and said that the disciples should do to others as he had done for them. He told them to follow the example that he had set for them, to serve each other and not think of themselves as greater than any other. Then God would bless them for doing as Jesus had taught them to do. The story of Easter, the Last Supper. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like calming storms. And even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
At this time, the Jewish people were celebrating a festival called Passover that had been celebrated since the time of Moses, when God brought his people out of Egypt. So Jesus was going to Jerusalem to celebrate. The disciples asked Jesus where he wanted to eat the Passover meal that night. Jesus said, "As you go into the city, a man carrying a pitcher of water will meet you.
Hello.
Follow him. At the house he enters, say to the owner,
hi.
The teacher asks, "Where is the guest room where I can eat the Passover meal with my disciples?" He will take you upstairs to a large room that is already set up. That is where you should prepare our meal. The disciples found everything to be just as Jesus had said. Later that evening, Jesus arrived with the 12 disciples. They sat down to eat, and Jesus said that he was happy to be with everyone. As they were eating, Jesus took some bread and blessed it. He said, "Take it, for this is my body, which is given for you." Jesus told them to do this to help remember him. Then he took a cup of wine and gave thanks to God for it. And he said to his disciples, "This is my blood. It is poured out as a sacrifice to forgive the sins of many." Jesus said, "One of you eating with me here will betray me." He told them that things were supposed to happen this way, but that great sadness would await the one who betrays him. The disciples were very upset and asked, "Am I the one? Who is he talking about?" Judas asked Jesus, "Am I the one?" And Jesus said, "You have said it." One of the disciples asked Jesus, "Lord, who is it?" Jesus said it was the one who he would give the bread to. He gave the bread to Judas, and Jesus said, "Hurry and do what you're going to do." None of the others at the table knew what Jesus meant, so Judas left at once to betray Jesus. Then Jesus comforted and encouraged the disciples. He promised them that they would have a helper come when Jesus was gone. They all sang a song to God together.
"이 시간 하나님 아버지께 예수님을 이 땅에 보내주셔서 십자가 돌아가시고 우리의 모든 잘못을 깨끗하게 해주셨음에 대해 감사 기도를 드리겠습니다. Let's pray to thank you for sending Jesus who died on the cross to clear all our sins. Let's pray. 아버지, 저희가 일평생 동안 예수님의 제자가 되어 늘 순종하며 예수님의 사랑을 전하는 친구들이 되겠습니다. We'll be a disciples of Jesus and follow you all the times until we see you in heaven. In the name of Jesus, Amen. 오늘 성경 암송 구절 같이 읽겠습니다. 예수님의 보혈의 피에 대한 말씀입니다. 한국말부터 시작합니다. 죄사함을 얻게 하려고,
죄사함을 얻게 하려고,
많은 사람을 위하여,
많은 사람을 위하여,
흘리는 바,
흘리는 바,
나의 피,
나의 피,
곧 언약의 피니라.
곧 언약의 피니라.
마태복음,
마태복음
26장 28절.
26장 28절.
이제 영어로 시작하겠습니다.
This is my blood.
This is my blood
of the covenant.
Of the covenant.
Which is poured out for many.
Which is poured out for many.
For the forgiveness of sins.
For the forgiveness of sins.
Matthew 26 verse 28.
Matthew 26 verse
28. Amen.
아버지의 이름을 거룩하게 하시며 계신 우리 아버지, 아버지의 이름을 거룩하게 하시며 아버지의 나라가 오게 하시며 아버지의 뜻이 하늘에서와 같이 땅에서도 이루어지게 하소서.
다 같이 기도드리고 예배 마치겠습니다. 하나님 감사합니다. 이 세상에 우리의 죄 때문에 오신 예수님을 기억합니다. 그리고 우리의 죄를 용서하기 위해 십자가에 달려 돌아가신 예수님께 감사드립니다. 그 십자가 때문에 우리의 죄가 깨끗하게 되었습니다. 그리고 제자들의 발을 씻겨주신 예수님을 배우겠습니다. 다른 사람들에게 예수님의 사랑을 전하는 우리 친구들 다 되게 해주세요. 예수님 이름으로 기도합니다. 아멘. Let's pray together and finish the worship. Dear God, we remember Jesus who came to this world because of our sins. And thank you, Jesus who died on a cross to forgive our sins. The Jesus the cross clean our sins. And we learn Jesus who washed the feet of the disciples. Let your kids be the disciples of Jesus who delivered Jesus' love to others. I pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.